The New York Auto Show is hitting the brakes. However, automakers and auto expert Mike Caudill are unstoppable when it comes to revealing what's coming down the production lines. Mike, what can you tell us?
Yeah, well, you're right. The auto show season has been disrupted a little bit. The New York Auto Show was scheduled to be happening this week, but unfortunately, due to the coronavirus pandemic, it has not happened, but the automakers are still launching vehicles, and they used this week, which would have been the New York Auto Show, to actually debut a handful of them. And this one over my shoulder is one of the ones that a lot of people are really excited about. This is the redesigned Lincoln Navigator. And if you take a look at this from an exterior standpoint, they've redesigned the front and rear LED lights, and on the inside, you're gonna get massaging seats with a 13.2 inch touchscreen. They have a new technology called Active Glide, and this is from Lincoln. This is their hands-free technology with this vehicle. So simply take your hands off the steering wheel and the gas pedal. The vehicle will drive itself. Really cool technology from the folks over at Lincoln. Now, Toyota showing off their all-new Corolla Cross. For me, this one hits home. This was the vehicle I learned to drive in. This one's actually a crossover utility vehicle. You'll be able to tow with it, and it'll be, for the first time, all-wheel drive, and it's going to be built down in Huntsville, Alabama. This is the world's best selling car of all time. Now, Lexus, we've been talking a lot about the NX lately. This one is the 450H Plus. It'll be a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. You'll get up to 36 miles on a single charge. And one thing Lexus is talking about is what's on the interior of this vehicle, the infotainment system. It'll be very much seamless to your smartphone. You'll get Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and a lot of great luxurious features on the inside of this vehicle. Now, Infiniti, I'm excited to be in front of this vehicle. I've actually test driven it. It's the QX55, and this is their sexy crossover utility vehicle. It's got 20-inch wheels. It's got a nice little turbocharged engine under the hood. The inside is completely luxurious and defined on the inside. Of course, Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and of course, you can see right there, plenty of cargo space. Now, big news that would have happened during the New York Auto Show is this right here. It's the QX60, and this is their midsize sport utility vehicle. Again, Infiniti going for full-scale luxury. This was thought to be a concept, but it's actually going into production. Dual stitch leather on the inside. I love that baseball glove color on the inside of that vehicle. Now, this one right here, I am super excited about the Nissan Ariya. This is a fully electrified all-wheel drive vehicle. You'll get up to 300 miles on a charge, LED lights on it. On the inside, you'll get two 12.3 inch touch screens. Pricing also just announced with this Ariya as well. You're going to be looking at a price just under $40,000. Now, with Nissan, it's all about A to Z, Ariya being the A, the Nissan Z being the hottest sports coupe of all time. You're going to get a twin turbocharged 400 horsepower, 350 pounds-foot of torque motor under the hood of this vehicle, and a 0 to 60 time of just about 4 seconds, and you'll get a manual gearbox, which is something no automaker is really doing today. Expect to see this going on sale in the next year. Now, just recently, the Grand Wagoneer was showcased out at Pebble Beach to give consumers a taste of what Jeep's new luxury full-size SUV will be. You can tell just by looking at the exterior of this, they are going for an all-new customer with this Grand Wagoneer. Lots of luxury, lots of leather on the inside, great creature comforts, and full three rows as well. And to close it out, I saved the best for last. This is the Jeep Wrangler Rubicon, and they're calling this their Extreme Recon Package. So you're going to get a 392 under the hood, which is a ton of horsepower, 35-inch wheels and tires, beadlock optional on the side of this vehicle as well. And then, of course, it is an off-road vehicle, so you're going to get 33 inches of water fording. You can take the doors off, take the top off. No pricing announced yet on this Rubicon, but I got to tell you, I'm excited to really take this thing off-road. So much stuff happening. Even though the New York Auto Show did not happen, we're still getting a chance to show off what automakers are bringing to market.
Go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.